Walnut, the city of Walnut is suing Mount SAC over the way it did its renovation and wants some more environmental impact clearances before they agree to or drop the suit. In any case, is USATF Indy at all legally involved in this? Do they have any interest in defending Mount SAC from this suit, or are they just watching from the sidelines?
I don't really know. I mean, that's a question that is really part of the business side of it, and that's a good question for Max Siegel.
Yeah.
Max is our CEO, as you know, and he's also happens to be an attorney. So I think that he would be able to best respond as to what USA Track and Field's role is, if any.
Are you personally concerned about the suit delaying the Mount SAC 2020 trials?
I haven't thought about it at all. I think that, you know, all I know about it is what I've read.
Yeah.
And I would think that organizationally there'll be discussions that happen between national office and that local organizing committee of that university to be able to determine whether or not it's really something that they should be worried about. And I really don't know.
Would there be any risk of losing Worlds in 2021 if the travel ban affected athletes?
Well, I think anything that's going to affect our ability to be able to bring the best athletes to the world who are qualified to be able to participate in the World Championships. So whether it's a travel ban, it's financial, whatever the issues are, those will be things that we'll be watching closely. And, you know, all of us that work in that arena are worried about any travel ban or anything that could impact any legislation. That political climate is not...
I should give you water.
That the political climate is a bit concerning, but we are 4 years away.
Yeah.
And I think if it was happening this year, I might have a bit more concerned about it. But right now, we're just watching what happens. Nothing so far. It's been difficult, I understand, for other meets in the United States with the process of getting visas, not just for those countries that have been identified, but even for all the countries. The process has become a little more cumbersome.
What is your message to San Diego runners who don't know what USATF is? What is the value to them?
Well, the value, that there's a lot of values to
it,
and trying to identify exactly what the message is what we're trying to refine right now.
Yeah.
I think what's really important is that I think one aspect that I would clearly do is that USA Track and Field, there is an opportunity for all to be able to be part of USA Track and Field, whether it's physically doing it, or whether it's being a spectator, or whether it's being a supporter, or whether it's someone that's coming in and taking a look at getting behind Team USA.